Hi guys, welcome to the Humble Monthly Bundle Rumble. My name's Aaron. How are you guys?
Oh god, this has to stop.
It was so sudden.
Yeah, I wasn't ready.
You hit recording, which means you're ready.
Yeah, I didn't hit recording.
Well, Caleb was obviously ready.
I didn't have my reviewing seatbelt on.
We never just start instantaneously.
Well, what if I'm starting something new, okay?
Oh my god. Okay.
Gotta get over it.
I'm scared. Do we still review the games? Or are we changing that too?
Polybridge.
Banging on all cylinders.
Yeah!
Yes! Woo!
The game where you build bridges in segments. It's very fun.
Super duper fun. I bet Jake hates it.
Well, I know it by a different name. I call it Tragic Car Accident Simulator. And I enjoyed it in that way.
But only that way. Only if you're wrecking cars in different ways.
Only if I'm building the least practical bridge imaginable, where I actually design it to go under the boats.
Ooh. Yeah, makes sense.
Mm-hmm. I had a lot of fun with that.
Does that actually
usually collapses.
Work?
You can build the supports to go under the boat, and it will technically work.
Can your car drive through the water, though?
I don't think so.
No, okay. No.
You can put them in the water, though, which is enjoyable in its own way.
Of course it is.
The name is kind of a pun, because the art style is, like, very flat polygonal, and you also, like, make polygrams out of, like, sticks and stuff to make bridges.
Thanks.
That's cool.
Thanks for letting everyone know, Alex.
Yeah, man, that was hilarious. I don't know how I didn't get that.
Super duper funny.
Very funny pun. I like it.
I thought the UI, just how you actually functioned and built bridges was difficult to know. I didn't really feel like there were a lot of hotkeys that made sense.
No.
And functionally building the bridges was also difficult. I kept hitting, like, escape or delete, and they weren't doing what I thought they would do. Just, it would be like, are you sure you want to quit? I'm like, no. I just want to go back. I just want to remove that bridge piece. After a little learning curve, I finally learned how to kind of do it a little easier with hotkeys, but it just wasn't very user-friendly up front.
You can make bridges where you do sick jumps instead of just driving.
I also don't like that feature.
I'm not a
Seems
big
like
fan
cheating.
Of the jumps. Yeah.
Thank
I
you.
Do like the multi-level bridges, though. I think that's cool.
Yes.
Bridges with, like, motorized segments that move and mm-hmm. allow ships to go through. That's cool. The ships can just crash into the bridge. That's You have vicious boat accidents as well.
It's a real treat.
Accidents. Yeah. Sometimes I give you a school bus that you know is full of children, and you're like, oh, I engineered this bridge very poorly to support these children.
Oh man, it sure would be a shame if something happened to these people.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
Oh, it's a fun game.
So vicious.
Yeah, I like it a lot. There's not much more to say about it, I don't think.
Nope. My biggest turnoff is the money cap. Because I want to build bridges that loop and just go into the distance, you know, with just wood everywhere. But eventually it's like, oh, that's too much stuff. And you can't.
Is there like a free build mode where you can do that?
I thought there was.
Is there?
I did not know
about it. I didn't look really. I just basically played a little bit of single player.
See, I'm like campaign. The opposite end of the spectrum, where I try to like build the most sufficient bridge with the fewest amount of materials possible to get vehicles across. And then I like review all of the, so after the game, after you've completed one of the bridges, it gives you statistics. One's for load capacity, one's for cost, and one's for, I can't remember what the third one is. Anybody remember?
Nope.
Okay, well, there's another factor it kind of grades you on.
Oh, it's like environmental footprint, right? Materials used.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, maybe it is materials used. Okay, but either way. I always, like, if I failed any one of those, I could not go to the next bridge until I got all three in green. Plus, I needed to make sure that I was at least, like, on par with what other people were doing.
Wow.
Percentile-wise? Yeah.
You're insane.
It was a struggle. But, all in all, I would definitely give it a thumbs up.
Me too. Thumbs up.
It's a yes for me.
Yeah, I'm gonna give it a thumbs down.
Aw.
Jake!
I know. I know it's rebel. Amazing that I'm not going to recommend a game I played in middle school. Like on school computers to learn about bridges. but no.
So much more polished than that, though.
It is.
I mean, sure, I guess.
Also, go look up crazy polybridge videos on YouTube. Or, like, GIFs on the subreddit, because they're amazing.
Yeah,
they are actually cool.
If you want a party, I'll tell you what to do.
Up next is Space Run Galaxy, which is the... Oh, gosh. This game is like building the worst-looking spaceship ever. I don't even know. It's just like a... The goal of the game is you're building a modular spaceship. You're moving through space in one frickin' direction. You can't change directions. And you build little modules. You add things like weaponry, shields, health, regen items. And you're carrying materials from point A to point B. And your ship, even though you upgrade it, somehow miraculously always starts with nothing on it.
Right. So I like to describe this game as a reverse tower defense. That's exactly what it is. Instead of you building up your defenses and sitting tight while monsters try to get past you, you build defenses on a moving thing and try to get past all the monsters.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't like tower defense to begin with, really. I also really, really, like you said, I really hate it that you, every trip you take, you're like, oh yeah, I just got rid of all the stuff I spent money on.
I realized I
spent time to build.
Yeah, it's efficient.
Yeah, you need different things for different missions.
Yeah, usually nothing. You know, when you start, you're like, this will be fine, there won't be any enemies this time. And you start and it's like, damn! There's bad spaceships.
Like, I know it's gameplay. Like, that's the reason why it happens. But I cannot suspend my disbelief.
Experience. Yeah. You can't believe that you're actually running cargo for Captain Buckman. Such an engrossing universe.
Oh, gosh.
Was he the character that you played as in the original Space Run game?
Original Space Run game?
Yeah.
I didn't know this.
Yeah.
Didn't
know that either.
Yeah, he says. Yeah.
Yeah.
Man has two N's in it.
Correct.
Oh, how original.
It makes it so much better.
How original. Also, this game, Jake, I feel like you when I play this game, I'm just completely bored out of my mind. There's no, like,
it's
speed
not a lot
up,
to do.
Slow down.
There's
you
no
don't even really
bridges.
Use your keyboard. You're just clicking and then... I don't even know. Do you even need to use your keyboard for this game at all? Can you literally just play the entire game with your mouse?
Yeah, probably.
I think you can.
Play the whole thing with your mouse, just jerk it with the other hand.
So we all recommend this game.
Yeah, it's pretty boring. Like, you, most of the time you're just sitting there waiting for your resources to get to a point to where you can click the next button to put another turret on a thing. And then
maybe
watch what happens again.
What I'm hearing you're saying is it's like every other tower defense game.
Yeah. They're all boring.
Well, but I feel like with tower defense, there's usually more... Like, the track is different, but here it's always like your ship. You always just want to shoot lasers, right?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I feel like there's just less...
Variety.
Just less going on, less to mentally deal with. It's like, okay, I need to put lasers on the left. Ooh, I need to put lasers on the right now. It's like, yeah, obviously. You need to put lasers everywhere. That's the game.
Yeah, it's very boring.
Very boring.
So all yeses, yeah?
Yeah. I'm going to give it a thumbs down.
A thumbs down, yeah, no.
No for me.
Oh, also a no from me.
All right, we agree on something.
Decision.
Yeah, wow.
This is great.
Oh, look what's next. It's Total Warhammer.
Total War Warhammer. Thank you very much.
That's a dumb name.
So as the name implies, it's a Total War game set in the Warhammer universe. Which is neat, I guess. I've never been into Total War.
Or is it in the Total War universe?
Whoa.
And Warhammer stuff has come to that universe?
Because
there's still
deep.
The regular factions, which are not in the Warhammer universe.
I guess that's true.
Huh. I didn't really think about
Who
that.
Who knows?
It's essentially just a Total War Warhammer mashup.
Yeah.
Oh, is that why it's called Total War Warhammer?
Yeah, but it should be called Total Warhammer.
Yeah, it should be called
stupid.
Total Warhammer.
Because that would be even more of a mashup,
for a it's name. Barely about Warhammers though, so saying it's totally Warhammer is just completely misleading.
How about I got nothing. It's total Warhammer's all I got.
How about War Total Hammer?
Ooh, but it's not totally about hammers.
It could be, though.
But it could be totally about Warhammers, too.
But it's not. That's where they get you.
What circular logic.
Thanks. Man, we've got real good stuff to say about this game.
It's an RTS, right?
Yeah. What do you mean, right? Did you play it?
I did play it.
I mean, it's like... The way I described it, because I've actually thought about like how cool it would be to have a game like this where it's Civ baseline almost. Like you make cities and you move units around, and then we actually get the units to fight. It zooms down in that, and you do like an RTS with the soldiers you have against the soldiers they have. So theoretically, you could have some epic like 300 type situation where you have a small army, but you're so tactically brilliant that you manage to win against a better force. I usually have the situation where I can't figure out how to move my units for 5 minutes, and then I die, because this game is impenetrable to newcomers.
Very dense.
Oh, yep. My goodness. It's very hard to figure out.
There is a lot going on. That's probably the most overwhelming thing about this game. I wish I could give it more time, but there literally is too much going on.
Yeah.
Even the starting tutorial mission, they're like telling you what to do. I'm like, I'm overwhelmed. I gotta go to something else.
Yeah, it's not newcomer friendly, and it's not like Civ where you can still kind of have a good time even if you don't know what researching pottery does. You know, like you can get pottery and you go, oh yay, pots now. This is like, okay, you need to move your unit, and it's like, how? You need to move into like three different stances just to get them to walk over there. It's impossible.
I don't have enough patience, I don't think, to learn it. It maybe could be amazing. Like, all the reviews are super good.
Oh, yeah. I have no doubt. Like, the little bit I did manage to get into, I had a decent enough time once I got, like, the baseline figured out. But getting there was so hard.
Which, the Total War series is always, like, super highly rated. But yeah. It just seems like...
But it's always like this, where it's super dense.
I think it's the kind of thing where if it's your thing, you are so into it that you know it inside and out. But if it's not your thing, like, you're just never, ever gonna even try.
Right. Especially with the pace that games have been coming out lately, that I just don't want to dedicate the time to it.
Sure.
Yep.
I don't enjoy the battles in this game too much, but the campaign thing was cool.
Yeah.
Where you build up your armies and move them around.
Where it's more Civ-like.
Yeah, I like
the overworld stuff.
Yeah. Actually, you can even skip the RTS battles in that mode, can't you?
Yeah, you can. You
and
can
just
auto
let the numbers decide it.
Yeah.
So, almost like a reskin Civ. Still less user-friendly than Civ.
Yes, very much so.
But, you know, decent.
I'm going to give it a new...
Yeah, I'd probably go the same route. As much as I like Warhammer, I'd give it a no as well.
I'll give it a yes.
So. Bum, bum, bum.
Yeah, I'm also going to give it a yes. But only if you have the patience for this kind of thing. Mm-hmm. And if you're okay with your Warhammer game not being exclusively about rats. Which, as we all know, I'm usually not, but, you know, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Is it time? For One Piece Pirate Warriors 3?
Oh my gosh.
Goodness. What a great game.
Please tell me you don't actually like this game.
I mean, it's Dynasty Warriors with a One Piece reskin.
Also,
and you know
just
what?
Way less good.
I like Dynasty Warriors. I had fun with this game.
All right.
You just go around and you punch everyone in the entire world. And that's enjoyable. Like, I wouldn't sit down and play this for hours at a time. But, you know, you come home, hard day at work, and you're like, man, I wish I could just be a pirate and punch a million guys.
Be a pirate made of rubber.
Yeah, do any of us actually watch One Piece?
No.
Good. We are definitely the people to review this.
I played my first match of this, and it was just like, when it got to the point where it popped up on my screen and said, congratulations, you've killed 3,000 people. I was like, okay. game. Let's just take a chill pill for 1 second. I actually immediately went to one of the secondary modes when I started this game because I absolutely did not want to play as Luffy. I hate that character so much. I don't know One Piece at all, but I hate all of the art, and I hate his stretchy body.
Oh, gosh.
So I played as some guy with a sword. I don't know. He looked pretty generic.
Was it the guy with three swords?
I was going to say.
Nope. That would have been better, I think.
We'll call him Sword Guy McGee.
Yeah. And I was, you know, you just kill swaths of people constantly.
Mm-hmm. That's an understatement.
And the camera controls are the worst things that I've ever seen in a video game.
Bad.
So bad. Who decided that the freaking paddles would be your camera control? Left and right trigger. Why?
Also, they feel backwards.
They are backwards. There's no feeling backwards. They are backwards.
Every time I tried to like move the camera right, I would hit the wrong trigger or vice versa. Like,
that sounds correct.
And then I would sometimes still try to move it with the stick and be like, oh, right, this game's retarded.
What is it? Does it use the right stick for anything?
No.
I didn't think so.
It's just there, not being used.
So makes total sense. Total sense.
There are like four combos.
Yeah.
They get old real fast.
Yep.
No, man, that's not the best part, though. You don't have to memorize all these combos. They're not hard to do.
Just
square,
so
square, triangle. That's the whole thing. That's the whole combo system.
So boring.
It's amazing.
One of the specials my character had, he just like kind of looks at everybody, and then hearts appear all over their heads, and then they all die.
So he's got McCree ult.
Does McCree make hearts appear over people's heads now?
Oh, he's got skulls.
I must have missed that patch.
They're like falling in love with him and like, I don't
giving
know,
up.
Committing
dying.
Or something. They're dying. Everybody's dying. I think with a better combat system and not One Piece, the actual way the battles play out would be kind of cool in a different game. How you have to like run around this kind of fairly large map and melee away through a bunch of dudes and control points. You run up upon bosses. And
literally the only thing that would... I mean, to make this game better, you just need to change from left and right trigger to the right stick camera control, and I probably would have played at least twice as long as I did.
Yeah.
Completely ruined that game for me.
I went in knowing this would be a reskin of Dynasty Warriors, and then I saw the menu system, and it blows my mind how exactly the same it is.
Yeah. They didn't even try to pretend like it's a different game.
No,
they
didn't. Apparently the third one.
How amazing is that?
Yeah, and also I found out we were really disappointed when that didn't have online multiplayer or co-op or whatever. And I found out the console versions do, but the PC version does not.
Oh, what? Freaking hate that.
What? So it's like the work was put in to put netcode into the game, but not ported to PC.
Amazing.
Even more dead to me now. Thanks for pointing that out. In case you're wondering, definitely giving this game a no.
Yeah, I'm going to give it a no also.
I'm certainly giving it a no.
I got to give it a yes.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
Obviously.
All right, Flat Heroes, a minimalist action game. The best game in the pack, probably.
Oh my gosh, it's so good. I love this game.
It's a whole bunch of different things, actually, really. Like, the main mode, I think, is just like a dodgy platformer thing. Like, you're in a little box and you're a little square, and you've got to dodge all of the bad stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And it's always like a different layout of the square, so there's a bunch of platforms everywhere, and you got to like hop around and make sure you don't get hit by bullets.
It's almost like N Plus, if anyone's played that.
Yeah, yeah. But like way more, like N Plus is minimalistic as it is. This is even more minimalistic.
Did you guys get as far to see you have a offensive ability?
Yes.
You can like explode around you, which was pretty cool because you can explode some of the things that are coming at you to help dodge them and use it to fight some bosses.
Yeah, so there's that mode, and then there's also a bunch of other modes too, like runner, battle, other things that I forget.
All of those are multiplayer, right?
Well, you can play against AI too.
Yeah. AI is really good too.
And AI is incredibly good.
I didn't have that experience. I feel like that AI wasn't very good.
Okay, I'm really bad.
Maybe I'm really bad too.
Is there like a difficulty level for the AI?
I don't know.
I didn't
see one.
I didn't either.
The one that was you were grabbing the little dot in the center, and then one person, if you didn't have the dot, you were like, if you had the dot, you were running away. Right. And the other person was shooting. And yep. That's one of the ones where I noticed you had the ability to explode things directly around you, because you could not only block bullets, but you could also get close to the other person and blow them up in order to make them reset somewhere else on the map.
Yeah, the first like 3 or 4 times I played that mode, I thought it was impossible because I didn't know you could explode yourself and I didn't know you could shoot.
Yeah, I didn't know anything, because the first time the guy picked up the thing and just ran away. And then every time I got close, he'd just blow me up somehow. I'm like, how's he doing this?
Yep. Yeah, so it's got a bunch of local multiplayer stuff too. So we didn't really get a chance to try out that stuff because we're all in like separate states practically.
Oh, don't break the illusion. Everyone thinks we're together right now.
We're all actually sitting around a table.
Yeah, we just said that to make you confused.
We all fly to Arkansas every month. Just to do
scenic
this.
Arkansas. It's got the best acoustics for recording. It works because it's so quiet all the time.
Nice.
But yeah, that seems like it'd be fun. Just playing against the AI, at least he could see the potential there for that. And mostly that one mode is just really good, that first mode.
The boss fights are also very fun.
I'd give it a thumbs up, definitely.
Yeah, me too.
Same for me.
Yep.
On to Rive, another platforming game. Though in this game, you play as a tank? Question mark. You're like
it's
this small
tank. Like tank adjacent.
It's a tank, essentially.
Tank adjacent.
You can jump around and shoot and like hover and stuff. And sometimes it puts you in zero gravity. But it's really sort of a action platformer mixed up with a shmup.
So yeah, it's a lot of dodging. A lot of dodging.
Mm-hmm.
And firing back towards where you dodged from.
Yeah.
Especially
it's a lot of just running away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you guys get to the frantic point where you were on a moving belt and you're basically just moving back and forth?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
I did not like the moving belt.
No, it just got overwhelming at that point, because you're not really shooting. You're just literally jumping to jump so that you can move faster than the speed of the belt.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Lots of things trying to crush you.
Mm-hmm.
Eventually they start spawning enemies too.
Yeah.
Does anybody know what the premise of the game is? Like, why you're in a tank thing exploring?
You crash landed, right?
Yeah.
And your tank's like your little mobile vehicle. Mm-hmm. Get out and explore.
Yeah.
The whole activating of cameras at the very beginning of the game, where he's like, activate a camera, and then it shows a photo of him. And he's like, oh, I look good. And then it changed his camera activation to, I can't remember what it was called. It was like side-scrolling platformer camera.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, dude.
Okay. Well, know what this game's going to be like.
It's a little meta.
Just a bit.
I don't know. I feel like it's meta, though, in the way that... what was that point-and-click adventure game? Doomsday Deponia?
Oh, gosh.
Was, where it's like... It's just so proud of itself for the little bit of humor it has.
Yeah.
That it, like, just ruins it. It's just like, oh, look! We're being meta, and that's so clever and funny. And it's like, it wasn't that clever and funny. Like, if you just do, like, a little thing, and you just leave it there, and you don't draw attention to it, like, it's fine. But if you do, like, the little thing, you're like, look! Look at the thing we did! It's like, you killed it. I feel like that was the vibe I got from the beginning of this game.
Yeah.
A little bit. Not as bad as Deponia, don't get me wrong. That was my main turnoff for that freaking game. And at least this one has, you know, gameplay.
I thought it was pretty funny. That's just me.
Yeah, clearly.
Like, it has really good particle effects. Like, things fall apart really nice.
Yeah, no, I like it when they explode.
Lots of bits and bobs everywhere. It has a good impact, I think, too. Like,
yeah.
Just the way it feels and the way you, like, hit the ground and stuff like that.
I'd say I'd give this one a yes.
I think I'd give it a no.
I guess I'd give it a yes.
I'll give it a yes as well.
Suck it, Caleb.
I don't mind being the only one.
That's good, because you are.
Up next is the next Morph Blade?
Yes.
The humble monthly debut.
The humble monthly debut Morph Blade. Morph Blade is a strategy puzzle game, and you are on little hexagons, yes. And as you move across them, basically it's when you move, the enemies move, or right thereafter. And as you move from hex to hex, you gain different weapon types, and you learn how to navigate using those weapon types to destroy the enemies, to open more hexes, to grow the map, to upgrade hexes, and so on and so forth. It's cool. It's unique. I didn't really understand the upgrade system all too well. That was the one thing I was probably most confused about.
Really? I thought it was pretty straightforward.
Yeah, same.
Basically, once you get a certain number of kills on one of the hexes, you can upgrade it based on the tiles adjacent to it. Okay. So, like, just, I guess, a quick overview of the tiles. There's a tile that lets you move two spaces instead of one. There's a tile that strips enemies of armor. There's one that just kills the guy next to you. Just bam, you kill him. There's one that heals you.
There's one that kills people on both sides of you.
Yeah, two different sides, but not in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's one... Did I say teleport?
No.
There's one that lets you teleport. And then based on that, you can upgrade the one that you are upgrading based on what's around it. So, like, if you're on the one that kills enemies adjacent to you but not in front, and you upgrade it with a hammer slot, it will also kill the one in front of it. So you have the potential to kill three guys. Or, like, you can get one adjacent to the acid one that strips armor to basically make any tile strip armor, if that makes sense.
Yeah, all that made sense, but I felt like a couple of the combination upgrades, I couldn't figure out how to get them to work. For instance, the one that is a arrow in combination, the one that is a saber that kills both the people on both sides of you. I never could kill both the people on both sides in the first tile, so I couldn't figure out if it was first based on the initial tile and then also based on the upgrade tile, or how the upgrade system worked when it combined two of those things. Does that make sense?
I think you have to go towards the tile that you upgraded from.
No.
To do it, don't you?
No. So whatever you upgraded on that tile, if you're on that tile, you get all of the upgrades that are nearby. Like, if you're on the hammer tile and you got the increased range and the ability to kill an armored person, you could, with one click, kill an armored person two spaces away, as long as you're on that tile.
Yeah.
It didn't seem like it always worked that way. Like, the blade upgrade, I just felt like it didn't... There was a couple times where I would move and I was like, that guy should have died.
Yep. I ran into that a lot.
I never had any issues like that.
Yeah, I'm going to say I didn't either, but I honestly barely paid attention to the upgrades.
Yeah.
Because I'm not a clever man. I would just upgrade a tile and then just randomly move and be like, oh, that tile didn't have that upgrade, and I'd die. I didn't do well at this game, for the record. It was just quite bad.
I think the highest I got was wave 29.
29?
Which got incredibly difficult.
29?
There are a lot of enemies.
Highest I got was like 16.
Yeah,
I think I hit like 18 once.
Getting 220 was very difficult.
Overachiever.
Yeah, I like this game a lot. I played it a lot. I found the best plan is to get a hammer in the middle of all the other tiles, and then once you get your like primary seven tiles, everything outside of that should be either the guy who jumps two spaces so you can jump directly to the hammer, or teleport ones.
To get to the hammer.
To get to the hammer.
You didn't ever get surrounded?
Not really. I mean, wave 29, I did.
Sure.
But okay. If you have teleport symbols, thank you, there we go, all over the map, you can just teleport to other teleports and then keep bouncing around until you get them where you want them.
That's true.
And then you can teleport to the hammer and punch them.
Fair.
Wow.
I guess the other thing we didn't mention is that you start with a very small number of, but as the levels go, you like add tiles and you select what type of abilities on that tile. So you can kind of shape the map how you want.
Mm-hmm.
Which is interesting. Again, I never used any type of strategy. I was just like, I feel like I want to tile on the left side today. And I would just go over there and be like, yay, it's on the left now. But theoretically, you could make like one that's a little like more narrow and long or something. Eventually, I assume you hit maximum size, but...
I definitely did not make it that far.
Okay. But yeah, as far as I could tell, you could shape it.
It's a very simple strategy puzzle game, but it's pretty fun.
It's something you can play for like 5 minutes and feel like you accomplished something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'd give it a yeah, even though I had a couple issues with it. I enjoyed it mostly.
I give it a yes.
I give it a yes also.
I would also give it a yes.
All right, the next game is Urnog.
The humble original.
Which they tell you in the game.
They do.
I kind of like that. You're like walking down a hall and then on the wall behind where you're walking, just it's like humble original. I'm like, oh, okay. We're doing that now. Which I guess goes along with the rest of this game because it's completely crazy.
Yeah.
I don't know how to describe this. It's like a puzzle platformer, I guess you could say.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With very unique mechanics.
It's kind of about picking up blocks.
Yeah.
Yeah. Picking up like throwing
living
blocks.
Living blocks with eyes.
Googly eyes.
That are different colors. And the different colors do different things.
Right.
And you can hold four things in your D-pad, which is like your inventory. Did you guys ever like pick up five different blocks, like four in your inventory and a fifth one that you're holding? And then jump and throw the blocks down and keep on pulling them out of your inventory and keep on jumping higher?
No, I did not.
Because you can totally do that, and it's awesome.
You get really high.
You get really high.
Yeah.
Yeah, so there's... I don't know how to explain how this game works. There's like worlds, I guess, or doors that are numbered that kind of act like worlds. Like the doors are puzzle rooms, and a lot of them you can't complete until you meet some qualification, like have a gun or have a specific type of bird.
The setup feels a little bit like Fez, I guess, with just the doors leading to different places.
Mm-hmm.
Only instead of Fez, it's just blocks.
There's like shops where you can like purchase items, and like you can send a whole bunch of stuff back to your little hub world that through like these teleporters, so you can keep it.
I like the hub world idea. It seems really interesting because you have this home base where you can drop stuff, and that's the only place that is saved across different times you open the game.
Yeah, I like how they say, like, this room will always stay the way you left it. Mm-hmm. Like, right up in front, they just tell you that. So you can make a little design with your little blocks, and it'll just be like that when you come back.
Or you could just use it to store all your crap.
Yeah,
that you need for later puzzles, which is what I do. I just throw it all in there. Occasionally some bombs blow some stuff up, but usually I have copies.
My favorite part about this game is that some of the shops, like the library and the gun shop or whatever, they have signs on top of their roofs. And part of the signs are like a symbol that you think is just like part of the sign. Like the library has a book up there. But if you go jump up there using like blocks to propel yourself up into the air to get up on top, and you pick up the book and then you read it, and it's actually a book from like the sign, and it just says, please don't steal our sign. And then I just immediately took it back to my home base.
Of course.
Or like, that's how I got the gun to solve the gun puzzle, was I just hopped on top of the gun shop and stole the gun from the sign. Also, another key mechanic in this game is that the doors are different sizes, so you can't, like, sometimes you can't carry something through a door because you'd be too tall and the door's short. That's all I got. This game is very strange.
I give this game a yes.
I'm conflicted. I think I lean towards yes. Like, when I first started, I was like, this is definitely a no. I think the stealing the library book thing put it over the edge for me. So I'd say yeah.
I'm gonna give it a no. I like the aesthetics. It looks really nice. It sounds good. I like the idea. It's not my kind of game. So I can't.
I give it a yes as well.
Excellent. Suck it, Jake.
No, you know what? I knew I'd be. I'm glad because it's a nice looking game. It's just, it's super not my thing.
Yeah.
So the time has come to rate the entire bundle.
Dun, dun, dun.
It's all right.
Yeah. It's got Flat Heroes, though, which was awesome.
Yeah, I think Flat Heroes and Morph Blade are going to save it. And obviously One Piece Pirate Warriors 3.
No.
No.
I think Flat Heroes and Polybridge make this.
Flat Heroes was the clear winner in this one.
Oh, yeah.
So good.
Mm-hmm. No, actually, I think this is a pretty good bundle because I've never even heard of most of these games. But you've still got the AAA in Total War. And technically One Piece, although I don't know if that even counts as AAA, maybe like B, two Bs. But yeah, no, I think it's a pretty good mix.
Yeah, I give the overall bundle a yeah.
Yeah, me too. I would thumbs up it.
I'm gonna give it a thumbs down.
Oh no.
This is not a bundle for me. I mean, I voted for several that were I give a thumbs up, but overall this bundle was probably one of the worst bundles that I've gotten.
Wow. It's pretty harsh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm gonna give it a yes. I feel like I'm usually the negative one at the end of these, but I'm feeling pretty good about this bundle. Yeah, thank you. We traded.
No problem.
This is nice.
I gotcha.
Now I'm gonna go direct trains and build bridges.
Yeah.
So we get to talk about The Witness now?
We do.
You guys have had this game for ages, right?
Like all three of you?
Yeah. I bought it the day it came out.
I think I bought it shortly thereafter.
Did you as well, Aaron?
No, but I played it off of Alex's account.
Fair enough.
I finished the game almost the same time Alex finished the game, actually.
Wow, so I'm the only one here who hasn't finished the game. So, The Witness is a puzzle game.
Da da da.
That's it, though. It's not like a puzzle game where you... It's a puzzle game where you solve puzzles.
And it's... literally the same type of puzzle with slightly modified mechanics for every single puzzle.
If you like drawing a line from one place to another place to meet super arbitrary criteria, you are going to lose your goddamn mind because that is all there is to this game.
That's actually pretty valid. I mean, it's pretty.
That's 100% valid. I haven't played as much of this as you, but that's all I've done. And I think it's why I'm not gonna like this game. Because I don't give a fuck about drawing a line. It's boring. I don't care.
It's not about drawing. It's about
drawing a line.
Extrapolating how you have to draw the line.
I don't care. It ends in drawing the line. I draw the line at drawing lines.
It's like based on things that are in the puzzle, based on the environment, based on sounds. Like... it's constantly changing and evolving throughout the entire game. And every single time you hit that point where you're like, oh man, is this it? And then it works. And you're like, oh my gosh, that's genius. And you get this like sense of elation where you are constantly figuring things out. It's great. My favorite puzzle game.
This game has pretty good puzzles. I enjoy the puzzles in this game. It really just has one mechanic.
Yep. Just drawing a line.
Which does get a little... tiresome throughout the game.
Yep.
But there is a moment in the game that pops up and it makes the game feel fresh again for a little while. And that moment is a really good one for this game. I think that makes it and is the only reason why I give it a yes, which I'm going to.
I will give it a yes as well.
I wasn't ending the conversation about the game.
We're ending the conversation. Buckle up.
This is supposed to just be a preview, which is kind of awkward because three of us have already finished the game.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I don't know. We'll talk more next month.
Yeah, okay, that's fair.
Yeah, in, a week.
But yeah, I'll give this a yes, obviously.
I mean, I'll obviously give it a no. I mean, I'll tell you guys right now, as soon as I saw The Witness was in the bundle, I said, ugh! I have to play more of The Witness.
I hope it's literally all puzzle games this coming month.
I will die. If they're all about drawing lines, I quit.
Yes.
I'm done.
Just line drawing games.
I will cry. I cannot deal.
How do we end?
Is that it?
I'm pretty sure this is how we end.
Yeah.
Bye, guys.
Do we win? Hello?